What is a TDA? The Titan Degree Audit helps keep track of a student's academic progress towards completing their declared major or program. It shows a student's completed coursework at CSUF, transfer coursework for undergraduate students, and courses in progress. It also shows which requirements have been met and which are remaining to complete a degree. The TDA is also the official grad check for candidates for graduation. The TDA is available for all currently enrolled undergraduate students, new undergraduate applicants, and select graduate post-baccalaureate students. Newly admitted freshmen will not see any courses unless they have college-level credits such as advanced placement tests. Newly admitted undergraduate transfer students will see a preliminary evaluation of their transfer coursework until records notifies them that the final evaluation has been completed. It is recommended that all current undergraduate students check their TDA regularly to make sure that corrections are done in a timely manner and it does not affect your ability to graduate on time. Graduate students should review their TDA with their graduate advisor regularly. To access the Titan Degree Audit, click on the Titan Degree Audit and Planner icon in Titan Online on the campus portal. By default, you will be on the Request an Audit screen and your current major will be populated. But let's click on Select a Different What If program to see what the student's TDA will look like if they switch majors. First, notice you can select a career. The default career will be for your current career, either undergraduate or graduate PBAC. However, you can run a What If TDA if you are an undergraduate student looking to apply for a graduate program by changing the career listed. Next, select a degree program from the list. Select your catalog year. Check the notes for this video for more information on how to determine your catalog year. Depending on your selections, you may see options to add an emphasis, track, minor, or certificate to this TDA. Click on one or more of these options to add them to the What If TDA. Now let's look at the advanced settings that are available for both current TDAs and What If TDAs. Select Click to view available options. Show planned courses is useful if you have added planned courses in the Titan Degree Planner. Showing these courses on the Titan Degree Audit can help you see if there are any additional requirements that have not been completed or planned. Check Show Planned Courses if you want the planned courses to appear on this TDA. Once you have your settings entered for the new audit, click Run Program. It may take several minutes for the TDA to run. You do not need to refresh your browser or click the Update button if you see it. The TDA status will refresh on its own. If you ran a TDA for your current major, you will need to click View Audit next to the audit once it is available. The TDA is now displayed on your screen. In a moment, we'll look at interpreting the information on the TDA, but let's look at a few tips and tricks first. By default, all of the sections on the TDA are expanded. At the top of the TDA, you have the option to close all of the sections. This can make navigating to specific sections of the TDA easier. Click Close All Sections. Now you can see that the sections are collapsed and it's easy to see which ones are complete, in progress, or missing. You can expand a section by clicking on it. Now I can see just this one section expanded. I can continue expanding just the sections I want to view, or I can scroll up and select Open All Sections. Now let's look at interpreting the information on the TDA. We'll start with the undergraduate TDA. At the top, the report heading shows important information such as major, degree catalog year, and anticipated graduation date if known. The charts and graphs are a visual representation of your progress in general education GE requirements, major requirements, and CSUF residence requirements. The categories bar graphs show the number of unfulfilled, planned, in progress, and completed units broken down by GE units, major units, and CSUF residence units. The cumulative GPA for each category is also shown. The snapshot pie charts show the total units out of 120 total that have been completed or unfulfilled, as well as the cumulative overall GPA. If you hover your mouse over a section of the graph, the exact number represented in the chart will display. Click on Course History to view a graph and table of in-progress and completed courses. The course history bar graph shows the number of units that were completed in each semester, along with the line indicating the GPA for each semester. Transfer students will also see the number of transfer course units that have been applied once they have been evaluated. If you hover your mouse over the bar graph, the exact number represented in the graph will display. If you click on a semester, the course history table below the graph will filter to show just that one semester's courses. The course history table will list all courses that have been completed toward a degree, as well as in-progress courses. You may filter these results by grade or by semester. Let's click on Audit Results to go back to the main audit. Let's scroll down to view the details of the audit. If there are unfulfilled requirements, you will see a notation at the top of the body of the TDA. Final evaluation will show the status of the evaluation of transfer coursework, if applicable. This section will also show the grad checkout status, when applicable. Contact information for the Office of Admissions and Graduation Units are listed if you have questions on transcripts or grad checks. The legend shows the symbols that are used throughout the TDA. The General Education Program section consists of the general education requirements, starting with the core competencies. There are symbols next to each requirement indicating whether a requirement has been met, blue checkmark, is in progress, blue icon with three dots, or has not been met, orange X. When a requirement has been met, the course or courses that met the requirement are listed along with the grade received. Where the requirement has not been met, a list of eligible courses appears. Be sure to check for any effective dates associated with an eligible course. In this example, Chem 111 only satisfies the GEB.1 requirement if it was taken in fall 2021 or after. Click on an eligible course to learn more about it. When you click on a course that meets a specific requirement, the university catalog details for the course appear in a new window, including which semesters the course is typically available. You can also click View Section Details to view if there are any open sections of the class in upcoming semesters. Close the window to return to the TDA. Courses that are in progress show as IP. At the end of the GE section is a summary of the units needed to meet general education requirements and how many units have been earned so far. The Major Requirements section consists of the specific requirements for the major you selected when you ran the TDA. The list of major requirement sections varies per program. Most include the following course types: core, required concentration courses, and concentration electives. All majors have a minimum grade point average requirement. For this major, biochemistry, there are basic courses, senior research courses, upper division electives, and biochemistry-related math, biology, and physics courses. At the end of the major requirements, the GPA summary for the major will display. The upper division writing requirement is specific to each major and will show if the requirement has been met or not. The graduation requirement indicates if the required 3-unit American government course for graduation has been met. Courses not specifically applied to above requirements shows any additional courses that count towards the degree not shown in previous sections. Special unit totals shows courses that count toward a specific maximum requirement. In this example, only 6 units of an internship can be applied toward graduation. Both times that the student has attempted an internship course show here, even though this unit maximum has not been reached. The Summary of Units section provides overall information on unit and GPA requirements. Unit requirements indicates units earned at CSUF, CSUF GPA, upper division units earned, residence upper division units earned, and major residence upper division units earned. Transfer unit totals applied to the degree indicates units earned and GPA from all of your transfer institutions, if applicable. Cumulative number of units indicates the most current total number of units earned that are applicable to the undergraduate degree. Cumulative GPA indicates the most current GPA for all attempted units applicable to the undergraduate degree. Lastly, coursework provides a historical listing of courses completed at other institutions and all courses enrolled in and or completed at CSUF by semester. Note, transfer courses that are applicable to the undergraduate degree are indicated by TRSFR and a 4-digit number. This section of the tutorial will cover how to interpret what you see on a graduate postbaccalaureate TDA. At the top, the report heading shows important information such as degree program, degree catalog year, and anticipated graduation date if known. The pie charts and graph are a visual representation of your progress towards completing the degree requirements. Click on Course History to view a graph and table of in-progress and completed courses. The Course History bar graph shows the number of units that were completed in each semester, along with a line indicating the GPA for each semester. If you hover your mouse over the bar graph, the exact number represented in the graph will display. If you click on a semester, the course history table below the graph will filter to show just that one semester's courses. The course history table will list all courses that have been completed toward a degree, as well as in-progress courses. You may filter these results by grade or by semester. Let's click on Audit Results to go back to the main audit. Let's scroll down to view the details of the audit. If there are unfulfilled requirements, you will see a notation at the top of the body of the TDA. Remember to contact your graduate advisor if you have any questions or notice any errors with the TDA. The legend shows the symbols that are used throughout the TDA. You will also see student standing and grad checkout status, which will show if a graduate student has been classified, and their graduate degree checkout status once applicable. Time limit for completion is a reminder that all requirements should be completed within 5 years, starting from the semester of the earliest course on the student study plan. Study plan courses consist of the degree requirements, starting with the required courses. Study plans will vary by degree, but generally they are 30 units total. In the above example, 8 to 9 units are listed as required, 6 units are listed as graduate level seminars, and 9 to 10 units are listed as advisor approved electives. There are also 6 units listed as culminating experience that is not seen on this screen. There are symbols next to each requirement indicating whether the requirement has been met, blue checkmark, is in progress, blue icon with 3 dots, or has not been met, orange X. When a requirement has been met, the course or courses that met the requirement are listed along with the grade received. Where the requirement has not been met, a list of eligible courses appears. Be sure to check for any effective dates associated with an eligible course. In this example, EGCE 430 only satisfies the Water Resources Engineering requirement if it was taken in fall 2024 or after. Click on an eligible course to learn more about it. When you click on a course that meets a specific requirement, the university catalog details for the course appear in a new window, including which semesters the course is typically available. You can also click View Section Details to view if there are any open sections of the class in upcoming semesters. Close the window to return to the TDA. Courses that are in progress show as IP. Next is Study Plan GPA Requirement and Graduate GPA Requirement. A grade point average, grade points divided by units attempted, of at least 3.0 is required for graduation with a graduate degree. This grade point average applies to all 400, 500, and 600 level units attempted subsequent to admission to a degree program, and all units required on the graduate study plan, including transfer courses. Repeatable courses are the courses the student has taken or is currently taking that are eligible to repeat. The limits on repeating the course are also indicated. Repeat unit limit shows any courses that have been repeated after not receiving a passing grade. Resident units requirements will list the courses units that the student has completed or is in progress towards this requirement. Graded unit requirement will list the courses units that the student has completed or is in progress towards this requirement. Lastly, coursework provides a historical listing of courses completed at other institutions and all courses enrolled in and or completed at CSUF by semester. To open or download a PDF version of the TDA, click on Audit Templates. Select Download Default PDF. Depending on your web browser, the PDF may automatically download to your downloads folder, or you may be prompted to choose a place to save the download. Some web browsers may also automatically open the PDF in the browser. To view previously run TDAs, click Audits. Select Manage. Click View Audit next to a TDA to view it. To view any TDA notes that have been added by an advisor, click Notes. All notes entered by an advisor will appear. On this screen is information about student resources. Undergraduate students, for misplaced or unevaluated GE courses, contact the Undeclared and Academic Advising Center at acadvise@fullerton.edu or visit their website linked in the notes for this video. For misplaced or unevaluated major courses or transfer coursework, contact the major department and the major department advisor can send a Titan Degree Audit exception if necessary. For other issues or questions, contact the Titan Degree Audit office at tda@fullerton.edu. You can also visit the Titan Degree Audit and Planner website linked in the notes for this video for more information. Graduate and post-baccalaureate students, for misplaced or unevaluated courses or transfer coursework, contact your graduate major advisor. And for any other TDA questions or issues, contact gradtda@fullerton.edu. All students should remember to rerun a new TDA after any changes, such as TDA exceptions, course enrollment, or major changes. And if you experience technical issues with the TDA or accessing it, contact the Student IT Help Desk at 657-278-8888 or studentithelpdesk@fullerton.edu. Thank you for viewing this tutorial. Additional resources and links are available in the notes for this video.